Hi, I am Antaryami and welcome to my channel. In this particular video, I will explain you the ecological amplitude and associated species types. So let's start with ecological amplitude. So to proceed with ecological amplitude, we first know about the ecological tolerance range of a particular species. So a species having an optimal tolerance range under a particular set of condition. Outside that particular condition, the fitness or productivity is reduced and there is a point after which there is a zone of intolerance. So based on this range, the ecological amplitude can be defined for a particular species. That is, every species has a specific range within which it can tolerate ecological changes. This range is called ecological amplitude. In other terms, the ecological amplitude is the degree of adaptation of a living organism to change in its environment. So, based on the response, the species now categorized into different subtypes. So, one is ecofins or echids. Suppose a man travel from a colder region to a warm-up region. So, the very first response is the darkness of its skin because of the production of melanin, but it is not a permanent. When it again goes back to the colder condition, the melanin secretion becomes reduced and it gains its original color complexion, that is the fairer. So, the variety of phenotypes from a single genotype that can be observed in a population due to environmental variation is called ecofins. So, when a species is transported to a new environment, its first response will be to develop abilities to survive there, like the melanin secretion in the warmer condition, and they adapt with some morphological changes. So, this can be reversible because no changes in genetics of the two separated ecofins, so they are belongs to the same species. Now, what are ecotypes? However, if two of these ecofins were to remain in their habitat for long time, these morphological changes will start become permanent. So, suppose that man now lives for longer time, so that darkness become persistent. And this persistence is because of certain genetic changes. So, in ecotypes, the adaptations are irreversible. That is, they can retain their feature even when placed in the neutral habitat. Now, it involves genetic changes, but there is no specific taxonomic rank because they belong to the same species. And why they belong to same species? Because they were not yet reproductively isolated. For example, Psychometrella patens, it have four different ecotypes stored in International Moss Stock Center. And this can be collected from, this information can be collected from Wikipedia. Now, ecospecies. If two ecotypes have been separated from each other for a very long time, the adaptation become permanent and their difference physically and genetically become very distinct. Now, we can identify the differences. So, the two ecospecies cannot produce viable offspring. They are not yet reproductively isolated. They can breed, but they cannot produce viable offspring. So, these ecospecies, after many generations, develop sufficient changes and become separate species. Now, they can diverge into two different species. So, what are co-enospecies? So, these different ecotypes or these different ecospecies which undergo occasional crossing do not produce viable offspring, as they collectively known as co-enospecies. For example, the breeding between mallard and pintail duck results in a mallard-pintail hybridization. This type of hybridization is estimated in 1 in 1000, as these two species, mallard and pintail, are reproductively isolated in wild. Now, there is more to two more concepts, that is ecotone and ecocline. So, ecotone is a transitional area between two different communities where two communities meet and integrate, also known as edge. For example, in this picture, we can see there is a meeting point of aquatic ecosystem and terrestrial ecosystem. So, this particular meeting point is known as edge, whereas ecocline is the gradation from one ecosystem to another when there is no sharp boundary between the two. For example, In marine ecosystem, there is no gradation of high saline zone and low saline zone, but few species are adapted to high saline zone and few species are adapted to low saline zone, because the habitat is different in high saline and low saline, but there is no separate gradation. Like in ecotone, there is a gradation in, or there is a separation point, that is beyond that it is aquatic and it is terrestrial. So there is a distinct separation, but in ecocline there is no distinct separation. We cannot distinguish between which one is high saline water, which one is low saline water. Similarly, the ecotone are of different types as represented in the figure. This can be due to many different things in many different types of ecosystem. So if this video will help you, then you can like it, share and subscribe my channel, and I will also add further informational videos regarding the preparation of CSIR NET. Thank you.